Hi there. Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. Firefighters rescued a man from a burning apartment building in Nashua this morning. Another resident of this five-unit apartment house on Main Street tried to rescue his neighbor, only to be forced back by the heat and the smoke. WMUR's Ray Brewer reports.
There were three people home around 8 o'clock Friday morning when the fire broke out at 371 Main Street in Nashua.
I live on the first floor, heard the alarms going off. Met my first floor neighbor at the front lobby.
Lawrence Kuhn says at first he didn't see or smell anything, but within a minute he could see a thin wisp of smoke through the windows.
So I grabbed my fire extinguisher and again tried to get up to the third floor, but there was too much smoke and heat.
Kuhn wasn't sure if his upstairs neighbor was home. It turned out he was.
The ladder company was ahead of the engine company, and they located the victim right away. Within 3 minutes, we had him outside, and we were doing CPR on him.
The victim was taken by ambulance to Mass General in Boston. The deputy chief says there was a little problem in fighting the fire.
It's a very long driveway, and so access was a little difficult for us to get around here and get lines up there.
The fire looked like it started in a bedroom, living room area, but that's still under investigation. The deputy chief says they were able to keep the fire confined to that one apartment, but it'll be a while before other residents are allowed back.
There's a lot of water damage down below, so we've done some salvage work on the first and second floors, but with the windows out on the third floor, all the power and the gas have been shut off.
Firefighters are trying to figure out what sparked an early morning fire that destroyed part of a trucking company in Charlestown. When crews arrived at Beaudry Enterprises on Old Claremont Road, they found one building engulfed. Officials say a second building was also damaged. Luckily, no one was injured. Authorities now know what caused an early morning fire in Hooksett. Firefighters say that a mobile home on Skyline Drive caught fire when a heat source was used to thaw water pipes. No one was injured, but part of the home was damaged. Fire crews are reminding the public to use caution when thawing pipes. A man is charged after police say he threatened someone with a gun over a parking spot. Police say this man became agitated when a tenant asked him to move his car from a parking spot near an apartment building on Cedar Street in Manchester. He then allegedly challenged the resident to a fight. He now faces one charge of criminal threatening. The Red Sox season opener is just around the corner now, and so are some new food options. How about lobster poutine? This is just one of the items that Fenway Park food vendor Aramark says that they are adding to the menu. Guests will also have the option of chowing down on a lobster melt and a surf and turf kebab. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, a new push to fight the opioid crisis. How communities on the Massachusetts and New Hampshire border are planning to stop the flow of drugs across state lines. Plus, a friend of an American killed in the London terror attack is speaking out. We're going to hear from a Granite Stater who was a good friend of the Utah man who died while celebrating his wedding anniversary. Those stories and more headed your way starting at 5. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.